As we make our way through the Westminster Confession of Faith, we look at the 11th chapter today. We begin a meditation on our justification by grace through faith. So let me read the first section of that chapter for you, and then make some comments, some judicious comments on the text. Hopefully. Section 1. Those whom God effectually calleth, he also freely justifieth, not by infusing righteousness into them, but by pardoning their sins, and by accounting and accepting their persons as righteous, not for anything wrought in them or done by them, but for Christ's sake alone, nor by imputing faith itself, the act of believing, or any other evangelical obedience to them as their righteousness, but by imputing the obedience and satisfaction of Christ unto them, they receiving and resting on him and his righteousness by faith, which faith they have not of themselves, it is the gift of God. The nature of justification has been central to the faith of the Christian church for centuries. We know that Martin Luther argued very carefully and very vigorously with regard to the nature of justification, where in his day, under the Roman Catholic Church, justification had been abandoned, or the scriptural doctrine of justification had been abandoned. Human works righteousness was allowed into the church in a wide variety of forms. Luther stood opposed to that, and so did the whole Reformed church, arguing instead that it is not by our righteousness, our good works, or anything that we have done that we earn or merit a right standing before God. Rather, we receive the grace of righteousness through faith that comes to us by the work of Jesus Christ. And it's only based on Christ's righteousness, his satisfaction for our sins, that we have a right standing before God. So this was the great battle during the period of time of the Reformation. Indeed, it continues even to this day. What is the nature of justification? How is a man made right with God? That is certainly the central question of life. How may I have a right relationship with God? Do you sense that you're outside of God, outside of fellowship with him? Is he estranged from you? Do you feel alienated from God and indeed hostile to the kinds of things he wants for you to do? This section of our confession explains the nature of how you become right with God. And it emphasizes the gracious character of justification. How God does not wait for you to perform something to earn his blessing, but rather he effectually and graciously brings you to himself, embracing you through Christ and his work. Our discussion of justification occurs following a conversation about God's effectual calling. Now God powerfully works in the lives of his elect to enable them with a new heart to see and embrace the truth of the gospel, to rest in the promises of God, to flee to Jesus Christ for forgiveness and everlasting life. God's effectual call is essential for our having any knowledge of God or a right relationship with him. And then we begin to work out how that effectual call brings us into a right relationship with God. And it is through this justification. Justification is a legal act on God's part. It is though we are called before his bar of justice. And all of our life is presented before God. Our good works as we perceive them, and all of our evil actions as well. And they are compared with God's perfect standard of justice and righteousness. And before the eyes of a holy God, who cannot look upon any sin whatsoever with any favor, before this God we all fall short God's perfect standard. There's not one human being in history, Christ accepted, who has fully, faithfully, completely, perfectly obeyed the will of God. From first to last, we are sinners. David said powerfully, "In sin my mother conceived me," commenting on his own sinful nature at the very start of human life. And so how may a sinner be declared righteous by a holy, perfect God? The answer is in Jesus Christ becoming our substitute. In Jesus Christ taking on the penalty of sin that the demands of justice presented. Jesus Christ bears that penalty for us by his death on the cross. And his perfect righteousness is communicated to us. Now we'll talk more about that in the weeks to come. But here, one of the things that the confession wants to counter at the very start is a number of Roman Catholic conceptions here, and we won't go through them all, but one that is essential here to discuss is that justification is not performed by the infusing of righteousness into us. That's a Roman Catholic conception which suggests that we are justified by our righteousness in that God enables us to live a righteous and godly life. And as we then begin to obey God, God sees those good works and justifies us accordingly, considering them meritorious. The contrast that the Reformers will make is between the infusing of righteousness, as the Roman Catholics conceive it, and the imputing of righteousness, the righteousness of Christ, which covers us, and it's the righteousness of Christ that justifies us, not the infusing of righteousness within us that enables us to live a good life. It's just another way of saying that we are not justified by our good works, however they are performed, but only by the good works of Jesus Christ. Many years ago, and with this I'll close for today, years ago I was taught by my fathers in the faith of the distinction between a Reformed conception of justification and a Roman Catholic conception of justification. For the Reformed is by grace alone, through faith. For the Roman Catholic, it's by grace plus works righteousness. So the contrast is between grace alone and grace plus works. And we say we're saved entirely by grace alone, as God provides everything that we need to have a right relationship with God. The Catholic conception is that Christ gets us started, but then we need to fill up the gaps, complete the goal by living a righteous life on our own. And this the Reformers rightly opposed by pointing to the Scriptures, which remind us that we are justified by grace through faith. And even faith is not our own, it is the gift.